Hello, I'm the great Orbax, and this is Dr. Mike Massa. Today, we're going to discuss the idea and the concept of friction.
Okay, so we've been doing a lot of problems with the force of friction, where that force is based on the normal force times the coefficient of friction. And here I've got, say, one object resting on another, a couple pieces of paper. The force of friction, when you pull these two apart, we would generally say, well, the normal force is the mass times gravity of the piece on top times the coefficient of friction, say something like 0.1. So we could pull these two apart, and there'd be a tiny force of friction resisting that separation.
Or I'm just incredibly strong.
There's
it's hard
that
to tell.
Too, yeah. Now, I mean, a piece of paper weighs about 4 grams, so it's a very tiny force. And even if we, say, doubled the mass by putting two pieces of paper instead of one, still the force of friction is going to be some small amount. The question is, what happens when you take away the force of gravity? Because we always think of gravity, mg, and the normal force.
And that's a common misconception with friction, right? Is that everybody's always looking at what's the force of friction. Right away, they make the normal force equal to mg, but it's not necessarily mg. The normal force is just a reaction force.
Right. So here, if I make these pages vertical, now the force of gravity is down, but the normal force is the contact between the two.
Right.
So what's the force of friction going to be here?
Well, if the normal force is zero, then just nothing.
There's
right?
nothing.
So what I've got here is two copies of your current textbook. This has got over 500 pages in each book, and I've painstakingly interleaved these pages one at a time for approximately 1 hour in order to get these together to hold each other like that. Now, as you see, we've got 1,000 pages now, all connected to each other, right? But how strong is this? We recognize the fact that I'm incredibly strong, and even I was able to pull apart two pieces of paper. Will somebody's weight be enough to pull apart this 1,000 pages that we have interleaved? Now, personally, I'm too important to actually be the subject of this test. However, Dr. Massa has volunteered to use his weight to try to pull apart these books.
Okay.
Star wipe. So we're gonna put these clamps on here in order to make sure that it's held tight. Now, there's something important that I want everybody to notice, and that's that these clamps aren't actually gripping these pages. We've got a substantial space between them. It's simply gripping the spine of this textbook. What we're gonna do is we're gonna attach it to this winch here, and we're gonna see if this is actually strong enough to lift Dr. Massa into the air. So we've got our books clamped together like this. We've got it attached to this winch here. Now, let's see how much weight this can actually hold. All right. Hey! It's working.
Not bad.
That's not moving at all.
How high are we planning on going?
So you might be wondering how this actually holds it together. I mean, when we looked at the individual sheets of paper, they just came directly apart because the normal force was zero. So how do we have, there's clearly only a force of friction acting here. It's the only thing could possibly be acting.
Right, but I mean,
how does this actually hold together?
The normal force isn't gravity, but it's actually the pages themselves being compressed and squeezing each other. If you look up here at the spine, you see that at the spine, the pages are beside each other, but they flare out to get the interleaved textbook between. So it's, they're kind of like clamping down on the pages in between.
So there's actually a component of that force that now pushes inward, that actually squeezes the book shut to tighten.
Yeah, and it's really cool because it's not just that twice as much paper is going to result in twice as much force. It gets amplified.
I believe the term's called geometric amplification.
Yeah, something like that.
And that's the awesome force of friction. Now get back to work.
Hey, Orbax. Orbax? Dude.